Hi guys, and welcome to yet another video. Today I'm going to be starting my first series, which is a let's play of Need for Speed Pro Street. Now, this is obviously because of the hype of Need for Speed 2015 that I can assure everyone is extremely hyped for. I cannot wait for that game to come out. So, in the time being, I'm going to play various amounts of Need for Speed games that I've got. Hopefully I can get my hands on Rivals. I don't have that, but I will get around to it. I'm going to start a new game. Yes. I've not played this game for a good 2-3 years. So I'm telling you, it's been a while. Damn, that 240 SX though.
Shinetown, make some noise! The top street racers have come to Chicago from all over America.
I genuinely think this was one of the best Need for Speeds made. Not the best. In fact, it's probably just got in the top 5 on my list, and that's purely because it's just a cool concept. The whole racing festival, the, you know, the gritty kind of, it's kind of like an underground sort of scene. It's not so, let's say, polished. Forza Horizon 2 and Forza Horizon 1, you know, they're at the festival. Yeah, it's street racing, but it doesn't really feel illegal. It doesn't feel like I shouldn't be doing that, or I shouldn't be driving that car at that speed on that road. You know, this Need for Speed gives me the street racing element that other games just don't give. So I think that's where Need for Speed holds its damn son. That Evo though. I'll get there. I think the last time I played this game, I bailed halfway through playing it. I've completed it before though, but that was back when in its prime when it first came out. But the last time I played this, like lately, I bailed because it's not actually an easy game. And maybe I'm a shit gamer, who knows? But it seems a lot more that the racing's a lot harder than the other past Need for Speeds. Nothing like Shift though. Obviously, it's an arcade racer, but it's got a hard. That's it. That is sweet. That would be something to see in the new Need for Speed. Coloured tyre smoke. Or obviously the tyres are coloured. That is pretty dope.
Real Watanabe, thank you so much for coming out today. Everyone here at Battle Machine is super.
I'm gonna take you down, sir. Yeah, you are going down, sir.
So I went something like this.
Can we get on with this race? Still? So I'm just gonna see how this goes. You know, I'm not gonna carry on if no one's interested and no one's watching it, because there's other things I could be doing. So I'm just gonna see how this goes. Like I said, it's my first series, guys, don't kill me. If I do anything wrong, or there's any, you know, things you'd like me to do better or see me do, then just let me know in the comments, obviously, and I'll make sure that I do it differently next time. Can't wait to customize my first car. I think you're gonna see a lot of time spent into that. Damn, this is the longest cutscene I have ever been in. Okay, we're starting. We're going. Okay, controllers are right. Controls. And while you're at it, guys, let me know what your favorite Need for Speed is. Let me know what aspects from your favorite Need for Speed you'd like to see in Need for Speed 2015. Like I said, tyre smoke, colored tyre smoke. That would be pretty cool if they did that. Don't think they will, but it would be pretty cool to see. Alright, the controls are a little different. I can deal. Ah, there's damage. Ah, I forgot about that. There's damage on this game. See, even for people that don't enjoy track racing games and enjoy playing open world races, they can enjoy this the same way, you know, they would enjoy an open world racer, because it's fun. It's not as serious as a you know, track racing game. Obviously it's not arcade, it's arcade, so it's softer, it's not as hard, it's not as brittle, and you can actually play it with ease. It's not something you can, you actually have to, you know, think about, let's say. It's not that realistic. So I think Need for Speed, when they made this, they made it for a reason. It's not just, you know, hey, let's make an imitation of a track game. No, pretty smaller. I don't know. I think the only issue I had with Pro Street back then, I wasn't such a car enthusiast. I wasn't really bothered about racing on tracks. I just liked racing my car out and playing around in a, you know, a 106 Peugeot with suicide doors and neon and splitting a split in the hood, and I'd be a race guy. I'd just drive around in my race car on Need for Speed Underground 2 back then. But now it's kind of different. But now I can give this game its justice it needs and it deserves, and you know, I think it's a brilliant game. Gosh, where are those guys? A bit of a walk in the park. So many people love this car. It's not my favourite at all. But the one in the trailer in Need for Speed looks dope. I know it's not a 240, I'm not gonna try and say the name again, I'll fuck it up. But it looks dope. Put your hands together. Yeah, I won. Real, man, come on, that was so... Of course I won. Yeah, me with the helmet. Me.
Yeah, okay, the guy won. But
I'm gonna get you.
Did not look pretty behind the wheel.
Got his name.
It physically pained me to watch that guy drive, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how.
Which I look very happy with what I just did.
Well, thanks for helping us out, Rio. It's real.
And can I add, for a game, the dude just totally, you know, that's been out for a good couple years now, it's... the graphics are not bad at all. The graphics aren't shit. Like, it looks decent. The smoke is good. I'd give this game a good rating, to be honest.
Hey, well,
it didn't hit limelight like the other Need for Speed stuff. Like, it's not on everyone's amazing Need for Speed, you know, history list. So, it definitely deserves a place, though. Yeah, your first race complete. So I'm gonna go for half an hour here, guys. Or until I feel like I've played enough, and then, you know, I might do 25 minutes an episode. So I'm gonna go until 25 minutes, basically. What's the situation?
When you build your car, you can't just put together
blah blah blah. Build cars for specific race types. Sell each car with up to 3 blueprints and share blueprints over Xbox Live. No, thank you. I would not like to share my blueprints. They are mine. So, create new. 10 grand. You know what? No, I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this. What we're gonna do is we are going to basically get our money, stack our money, do a bit of grinding first, and then I'll customize my car. That might not be in this episode, but I'm gonna get onto it. But there's no point in me wasting my money on my car right now.
No need to bring your whip. Battle Machine is providing all of them. Just don't ask where they got them.
Got it.
Anyway, to level the playing field, every car has been hand tuned equally.
Got it.
The cars are ready. All you gotta do is drive.
Got it. Now, let's talk a little bit about Need for Speed Undercover. My bad. 2015. How did I even get that mixed up? 2015. I can't stop talking about that game. It basically is going to consume my life when it releases. Okay, let's listen to this for a second.
But generally, they're all about being the fastest car on the track. Rip races feature a bunch of drivers.
Got it.
Are gunning for the win, which makes for some dangerous moments. Fast reaction times will keep you in the race. When you're coming into tight corners, use the arrows and driving lines to pick the key spots.
Got it. Damn, that Evo looks nice.
But try not to put yourself in a bad situation.
Ah, RX-7. RX-7. I've just been reminded. RX-7. That is the car I'm going for. I don't know when I'll get there, but that car is on my wish list for this game. It is. Wish list. I'm gonna get that. I'm getting that car. It's one of my favorite cars ever. Oh, damn, it's messed up. Yeah, that is one of my favorite cars of all time. If that is on Need for Speed 2015 with a white Rocket Bunny wide body, wow. Wow, that is all I can say. Wow. That's a lot of goals. But yeah, back to I was speaking about Need for Speed 2015. I really think that the fact that they're rebooting the whole franchise, or gaming franchise part, and you know, they're just totally revamping it. Ghost Games are going to do an amazing job, I can already tell. Some of the creators and developers have even tweeted saying that was in-game footage, like in the engine, game engine footage, like it wasn't a cutscene. So, oops, that means basically that they're the graphics. Now, I don't know if they'll be close when we're actually playing the game, like actual gameplay, if it will look like that, but if it does, my god, I will enjoy playing that. And that game will be played for... I will not come off that game. I think this channel will revolve around that game when it comes out. Just to let you guys know, just to pre-warn you. I'll be talking about it up to the, you know, development two, development release. So, look out for that. You'll see it. I don't think I'll be able to not play that. In fact, can we get rid of... Let's see what King is. Whoa, okay. Okay, let's do this. Right. See, these tracks are not bad. They're just, they're nice. You know, they're not too hard. And this is the thing about Need for Speed. It's not a serious game, and that's what I've liked about it. It's fun. You know, it's fun. The crazy body kits, everything. It's just enjoyable. And I think that's one thing a lot of games just lack, is just a bit of fun. You know, just some crazy body kits. Stupid customization. It makes playing the game a lot more fun, because you know, something to grin at, you know, something to wow you. I mean, on Forza, don't get me wrong, it's a brilliant game, it's amazing, but it's just really not dull, because I love Forza. I've been playing Forza since the first game was ever released. I cannot say that I'm not so fan of Forza. I am. But it's just a tad bit boring, if I can say that, when it comes to customization and stuff. It's amazing with the tuning and that, which would be amazing if the new Need for Speed had that, wink, hint, but I don't know if it will, but it doesn't need it, it really doesn't. It's going to be amazing, I know it is. I'm swaying a bit off topic here, let's get back into the game a bit. Need for Speed. I didn't think I gave this game a chance. And that's one of the things I regret. Because when I bought it later on, I enjoyed it a lot. and I regret that I didn't ask when I was younger. I asked for it at least. I should have, and I do regret that. And I was just having a discussion with one of my friends the other day, and it was more of an argument, and we were talking about how basically I didn't buy Rivals because it didn't appeal to me when I watched the trailers and watched the gameplay and heard about the game. Apparently I was wrong for that, but I don't know, am I wrong for that? Tell me, am I wrong for not buying Rivals because of what I've seen? You know, I didn't get it because I just didn't think it would have interested me. You know, customization is a big thing for me on car games, and the fact that there was none of that, it didn't, you know, attract me at all. So I just didn't get it. I didn't say the game looked bad. I didn't say the game played bad. I've never played it, so I can't really judge it like that. But I just didn't buy it because it didn't pique my interest. Like I said, Rivals probably isn't a shit game. Probably good. Probably good. But it didn't get me hype when I saw the release of it. I wouldn't say I'm a hardcore Need for Speed fan, but I'm definitely a fan because I've been playing it since I was little. Since I was a little boy, so I can't, you know, say I'm not a Need for Speed fan. But it just didn't get me enough to buy it. In other words, Need for Speed 2015 will get bought, pre-ordered. Limited edition, collector's edition, whatever. I am getting that shit. Wow. I will live stream that shit. That game was getting played, guys. Played. Much like this. A lot of Let's Plays. I think why Pro Street stands out from a lot of the other games is the fact that it's more of a not as serious, I didn't say it, I said it wasn't serious earlier, but obviously it's not open world racer, it's not street racing, it's legal, and at the start of this game actually it says let's get racing off the street, so I guess it's kind of a promotion of stop street racing. Not good when they come back bringing other games out on the street though, but no, it's good, it's a good game. If you have this game and you haven't played it for a couple years, or if you've not played it ever, then I suggest you go back and play it, because it's decent. It's a decent game. As I know, this racing is a little bit boring, so I'm gonna just go to the garage. I didn't read that, I should have. I'm gonna go back to the garage, I'm gonna do up a car, and then I'm gonna wrap it up for this episode. So let's go into cars. Car lot. Nope. Wrong thing. Garage. So I've got 13. I've only got 3 grand more. But whatever. I'm gonna do this. I can't reset it. I can't alter it. Ah, great. Okay. I'm gonna just do the looks for now, I think. Just the looks. That would take my whole 15 grand, so I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna get the first one. Cute. Zone 1. Let's get this really flared, guys. Let's go crazy with this one. Little bit of a lip. No, let's not be stupid. There. Rear bumper. Raise that up. Raise that out. Raise that down. Yeah, everything can go up on the back bumper. Doesn't look too steep. Whoa, go back. Whoa. Okay, looks good. Skirt. Flick that out a little. Lower that a bit. It's all good. Right, that's the body kit done. I've lost 9 grand. I mean, I've got 9 grand now. Exhaust tip. Let's have a look at that. No, they ain't important. Not right now. Wheels. All wheels. Oh, all wheels. I want to cheat. Go cheat from cheap and cheerful, guys. Let's stay under 2K, shall we? Cheap and cheerful. This is our first car. We don't need to go too overboard with this. I'm gonna go with these, and then I'm going to white wall. Should I go for no? Go there. Deep dish these bitches. Well, no, it's not. Let's make them tires wider. Add a bit more tire there. And then we'll go to the rear wheel, do more or less the exact same thing. Deep dish. Widen that. And voila. Wheels on fleek, as they say. Get some racing seats in there. One racing seat. Ah, that is cool. That is another thing they should put in the game. I'm gonna go for yellow. That is another thing I'd love to see. A bit of, you know, interior customization. Yeah, I haven't seen that since Midnight Club, so I'd love to see that too. The auto sculpting aspect of this game is so cool. I would love to see that being added. If they will add it, I don't know. I'm not doubting it, because I can't really doubt anything they do now, because they have outdone themselves with this game, Ghost Games. They've outdone themselves. So I cannot say that. Do I even like that spoiler? Yeah, let's go with it. Big spoiler. I can't say that they won't do it, but I'm just not going to get people's hopes up saying they will. So please do not take any word from me. This is just me speculating what they will do. I'm going to go for a nice, juicy signature J-Red. All that. And then for the wheel... In fact, let's change the whole. So I want a carbon book. Wheels. Whoa! You have to select them? Okay, sorry, I have to apply paint. My bad. Ah, you can change the colour of the actual. Oh, this is. This game is cool as fuck, guys. Come on. Go gritty. No, let's not do that. Let's not do that. Bad idea. Right. Wheels. I didn't do wheels. My bad. You don't do wheels here. They do wheels. Let's have a mate black. My bad. Mate black. Matte black. Mate. I like that chrome lit. Window tint. That covers up the yellow seat. Yeah, I like that. That's nice. Yeah. So, yeah, guys, this I'm going to wrap it up there. So let me know if this series, you know, if you like it. Let me know what I'm doing wrong, what I'm doing right, whatever. I think I want to continue this, but I'm like I said, I'm going to see how the views go, see how people, you know, respond to it. And then, yeah, I'll probably continue it anyway. But if it goes wrong, no one watches, no one likes, then probably not. So, yeah, guys, this is it. Leave a like if you like this. That bumper's not the right colour. Yeah, leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe, comment, all the stuff there. And yeah, I'll see you soon, guys.